looking at the Caldwell Lead Sled DFT 2 gun rest. And I'm making this video today to really talk about the weighting system for this gun rest. On this one, they went from going from the large hard weights you use for working out to soft weights, which is I really like the idea of that. The soft weights are a lot more forgiving if you bump into something or drop them on your toes, or you can just load them in your truck. It's a lot easier to deal with them than the large hard weights. So I will say that I've used it one time. It seems very well built. Only took me probably 10 minutes to put together, and it was a big help at the range with all the fine tuning that it has. So I originally just bought the Caldwell here. I didn't buy these bags with it. Back up here a little bit. Because I wasn't sure what I was going to do for the weighting system. And of course, you can read on their website, and it talks about you can fill these bags with sand, lead weight, steel shot, whatever you want. So when I started looking around, I was going to get the lead shot. I realized it's pretty expensive. I think one of the best deals I found to get 50 pounds of lead shot was, I think, on Amazon for about $120. So I started looking around, and of course you could do what, you know, they can recommend putting sand in these, but the volume of sand that you could get in these versus putting steel shot or lead shot in these bags is a lot different in the weight. You're going to get a lot more weight with going some kind of pellet. But $120 I thought was a little steep, a little more than I wanted to spend just to add some weight to this. So I did a lot of looking around and come across... This is called, let's see here, leadweight.com. And there's a lot of different companies out here that do this. And these are boat ballasts for wake boats. And I was able to get 50 pounds for, I believe it was $67 delivered. So it was a little more reasonable. I went with lead weight here because looking at the measurements for this, I thought it might actually fit directly into that slot. And on paper it would, but with these ridges and stuff, I just couldn't get in there. It was very cumbersome, so it really wasn't worth it. And trying to deal with 50 pounds of weight, putting it on there wasn't easy. So I went ahead and broke down and bought the Caldwell bags. So my intent here is to divide these up into these bags. I'm just going to have to play with it, see how much I can get in each bag to make it fit in there. Because I can already tell if this thing is a little larger, if they were completely full, it wouldn't fit under here. So I'm just going to have to see how much weight I can put in there on each bag and get under there. So I'm going to use my little tub here because I don't want BBs all over the table or the living room. And start working with this. So what I plan to do is just really cut it right here to open it up. And I'm going to do that because, one, I hate to even cut it. It's a good sturdy bag, double stitch, really made to handle this weight. But the reason I'm going to do that, you'll notice when I pick it up, it just wrinkles here. It doesn't have any pressure, really, a lot of pressure right there. So if I decide I want to reuse this bag, like maybe fill it full of sand and I want to sew it up, just use it for a sandbag for shooting, then it's not going to have pressure on my sewing because I don't know how to sew. And another option you might have for some people to do the same thing is if you still want to just use this bag on the Caldwell there, you could probably just cut it and just take enough out so that you could slide that under there if you don't need the whole 50 pounds of weight. And honestly, the gun I shot was a 270. It really doesn't kick much, but I do have a 30-06 lightweight that being a lightweight, you feel everything when you're at the gun range. So it'd be real helpful with that one if I can go and get the whole 50 pounds on there. So I'm just kind of experiment here and see how I can do it, and then I'll come back. All right, I'm gonna show you what I got so far. Well, the biggest thing I got so far is a mess. I learned when I opened that up, these have a coat of oil on them. And I believe that's because they're steel, not lead. Despite the name, Lead Weight, that's just the name of the company. And I believe I read in their description that they use steel. So you can kind of see what these pellets look like. And for whatever reason, maybe to help preserve it, they have a good coat of oil on them. So it is a little bit messy. So you definitely want to use something like this, even using that. You see I've got stuff here. So I've already got one on there, and what I've realized, if I just fill these up with this right to about where the zipper starts here, I don't know how you can see that, it's just enough where I can get it in here. So, you know, all the weight's going to kind of drop to the bottom, and then just kind of pick it up, shake it, even it out, and it slides under there pretty good. But I don't think I could go with too much more and still get it under there. You kind of see how much space is left on that. So once you get it over to the lead sled, you got to turn it sideways, even them out a little bit, and it slides under there pretty good. Now, I did learn, and I don't know what I want to do about this yet. You're going to have to make sure, when you zip this over, it's hard to do here with one hand, so I'm not going to try. But when you get it all the way down to the very bottom here, you know, like any zipper, there's still a little bit of a gap. So you got to get that zipped as best you can and be careful. I may actually take, once I'm done here, I may put a little Gorilla Glue or something in there and just try to hold that zipper in place and keep it from leaking out right there. So I still have a lot left, so I'm going to still work with it and see, I'm going to divide this up and I'll come back again. All right, so here's what I've come up with that I think is going to work best for me. So I have two of the bags slid under directly onto the shelf that's made for them. And those are 16 pounds a piece. Then I took the other two, divided the weights on them, and just kind of put my hand in there like this and put them on here. That way I'm separating the weights so the weights are actually sitting on the other bags, but lets me get them up there. So I'm obviously not going to get all 50 pounds on the sled there. The other one on, just like that. And you do have to do this knob, so you might have to manipulate right there, your tension knob there. And I think that'll work pretty good. I see this rifle up here just to show there was plenty of room for that. And I don't know if it hurt to actually set the weights on top of this, but doing what I'm doing, the weight of the bags are actually setting on either side. So, I think that'll work. So that'll let me get all 50 pounds on there. And depending on what I'm shooting, with those being 16 pounds a piece that I put on the bottom, it's probably plenty for the 270 outside in. This is that 30-06 I was talking about, that you feel it when you shoot it. So I think I'd want all 50 pounds on there. You see, I have this sitting on a towel, by the way. This is that's a hard plastic here. So that will scratch your table, as my wife pointed out to me. Probably ain't gonna help me any when she figures out I used her measuring bowl to help with this. And despite my best efforts, I did get pellets on the floor here and there. So I'm gonna have to vacuum. That's all right, sometimes a man just has to vacuum. Alexa, tell Roomba to vacuum the dining room.